555 Jacksonville.
I feel like I can do it all. You know, I did so much when I was at Buffalo, whether if it was, you know, catching deep balls or, you know, lead blocking through the C gap. I mean, I feel like I'm very versatile and can, you know, play any type of game that need to be played, whichever week.
Here's Allen, taken to the right, going to the end zone. And who else? Gabe Davis with the touchdown catch on the opening drive.
You know, I think it's going to go very well. And, you know, I plan to have a long career. You know, I think I got a good 5 or 6 more years in me. So I don't plan on stopping anytime soon.
I done did it before, going to teams that didn't really have it all the way together. Then, like, early years, a new head coach and stuff. You got to deal with just that early year. But, like, I know this team, you know, is moving forward, moving up.
1010 XL 92.5 FM presents Jaguars Today with your hosts Mike Dempsey, Tony Smith, and Dylan Denmark.
All right, good morning, everybody. This is your official 4-week warning. The NFL draft is coming, and they're not going to reschedule. Not that we want them to. Tony, by that point, we'll be several months overboard on how long we care to talk about it.
Yeah, I got my own rescheduling issues for today into tomorrow with opening day for the Braves, so I would appreciate the NFL draft happening when they say the NFL draft is going to happen.
What, Braves not playing today? I thought all the good teams played on opening day.
Not until tomorrow, I heard.
Opening day today. Good teams playing today.
Yeah.
Only one I care about. The only team that's good as far as I'm concerned. I'm decked out head to toe. Pockets! How you doing there,
bud? I'm all right. Chilling.
Chilling? I need more energy out of you, man. What's going on with
man,
you? Are we wearing you down?
Killing me. We got to get some sunshine back in the weather, man.
Yeah, we've had sunshine for like 89 days out of the last 91 days.
We got to practice,
some craziness.
Man. You got to practice.
You can't run indoors?
I'm talking about practice, man.
You know,
no,
the,
ain't got
a
no
beautiful indoor track facility at Baldwin?
That'd be a negative.
All right. You can't run on in the wet?
Nah.
No? It's too slippery?
Oh, we can, but we're kind of lazy. We're just like, hey, man, y'all just
we're kind of lazy.
Yeah, we'll just go home, man. Y'all just, we'll figure it out tomorrow.
All right, Pockets. We thought about doing a whole big thing where we'd suspend Pockets for Friday, but he's just taking the, what are you taking the day off for, Pockets?
I'm going down to Florida. We got Florida relays running, got a 4x1 at 800 tomorrow. Florida relays is pretty fast, so we got to get to work.
You got a 4x1. What do you have?
We got our 4x1s running at Florida Relays tomorrow, okay. And we got a girl running 800.
Oh, an 800. Okay.
Yeah.
And okay, I thought you were talking about one long thing there, Tony. I didn't know what.
My bad.
He was getting
I just get used to it. I think you know track stuff and you don't, and then I just
don't.
Kinda, I'll slow it down next time.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Oh, I know what a 4x100 is. I know what an 800 is. He's what generation are you? Gen? What?
I don't know. I'm 98. I'm like at the break point of like
Gen question
Gen
mark
Z and Gen X. Something, I don't even
new
know.
Alphabet.
Yeah,
coming, incoming.
I don't know.
All right, ET's going to be in here tomorrow. Can he handle this show?
I don't know.
Been a while.
I was asking. I was talking to him.
This is a very labor intensive program. Turn on the mics and go. Today we got John Shipley stopping by from Jaguar Report, and we'll get to all the goodies with him. We had LSU having their pro day yesterday. Jags certainly have plenty of players to keep their eye on there, even though Jaden Daniel, not one of them. We have our eyes on who he's throwing the football to at his pro day. So we'll talk about that coming up. Tony, got today's question of the day out there. D-Rock on Monday told us he is pretty optimistic Jags might be able to get something done even by the NFL draft with Josh Allen. That's his opinion on it. You know, the deadline for getting a long-term extension this offseason for a franchise tag player is July 15th. If they don't get it done with Josh Allen, obviously he can play on the tag. The Jags would have the option to negotiate with him at some point during the season, but they typically don't do that. So we're asking you today, when it comes to Josh Allen and the Jaguars getting a long-term deal done, how's it going to go? Will they get one done by the draft? If not by the draft, and I put it by July 15th as the second option. Well, obviously the draft is by July 15th, but you get what we're trying to say here.
There's one deadline of the draft, a second deadline
right.
of 15th.
And so the second option is somewhere between the draft and the July 15th deadline. In other words, they're going to focus on the draft. They'll get that taken care of. Then they'll spend some time focusing on Josh Allen.
If you think they're going to get him signed by the NFL draft, vote appropriately. right? Then correct. Vote before right. the NFL
right.
draft.
Vote before the NFL draft, yeah. obviously, right, if you think it's going to be earlier. Then the next option would be next offseason. And you say, well, next offseason, he's only on a one-year deal. Well, yeah, the Jags can franchise tag Josh Allen again. Mm-hmm. And they could work prior to that deadline next year to try to get an extension done after the season. So if they don't get an extension done by July 15th, doesn't mean Josh Allen is playing his last year with the Jaguars this year necessarily.
No.
Right? Could be, could not be. Could a lot of different scenarios come into play. So your options are going to be by the draft, by the July 15th deadline, sometime next offseason, and that would include sometime during the year, but we just know that that's not been Trent Baalke's MO.
Yeah.
Or they're not going to get an extension done with Josh Allen, which could mean a number of things. He plays it out on the one-year tag this year, and he tries out free agency next year, leaves, and the Jags ultimately get a compensatory pick. Maybe they tag him again next year. He plays 2 years on the tag. Maybe they tag him and trade him next year. There's so many different ways mm-hmm. it could go with Josh Allen. What's your gut tell you about how it will go as of this morning? So those are your options. You can vote accordingly on social media, on Twitter or X, at MD_1010XL. Don't forget at 1010XL Fat Tony and at 1010XL Denmark.
Ain't no laws when you're drinking claws, baby.
Doug Peterson just keeps running his mouth. This guy. This guy over here. Put a mic in front of Dougie P. We love it. 35 minutes at the owners' meetings. He also went on Sirius XM, NFL Radio, at the owners' meetings. And so we've got some leftover thoughts from Doug Peterson that we haven't got to throughout the course of the week, and we'll get to those coming up today, and we will dig into that LSU Pro Day a little bit as well. John Shipley, by the way, is about 25 minutes away, so make that appointment listening from Jaguar Report coming your way with Tony Smith and Dylan Denmark. I'm Mike Dempsey. We are underway at 641-1010 on the All-Pro Roofing phone lines or the text line designed by Lifetime Enclosures. Let's talk about those LSU prospects when we return and how they might fit with your Jacksonville Jaguars on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Jaguars Today from the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute Studios.
I wanted to be a senator.
I wanted to be a florist.
International house pancake.
1010XL, where sports radio dreams come true.
At Randy Marion Cadillac in Jacksonville, we have over 40 2024 all-electric Cadillac Lyrics in stock.
Take advantage today of two awesome incentives.
First, a $7,500 rebate applied to the purchase price directly at signing.
That's a $7,500 rebate with no need to wait for tax time.
And second, a $1,500 credit for a high-speed in-home charger.
Over $9,000 in savings.
Now's the time to drive away in luxury in a brand-new all-electric Cadillac Lyric.
Randy Marion Cadillac, Southside Boulevard, Jacksonville, plus tax tag title $899, admin fee and resist-all.
Tell them Jennifer sent ya.
Are you embarrassed by your ugly, cracked concrete driveway? Need to enhance your home's curb appeal? StoneCore on Phillips Highway is your one-stop shop for all your outdoor needs. Replacing with new stone pavers will transform your driveway into a stunning work of art. Say goodbye to unsightly concrete and hello to beautiful, durable pavers that'll last for years. Visit StoneCore today and let's beautify your home together. StoneCore.co. We do outdoors better.
Certainly facing challenging economic times, I can't speak for all of us, but for me, comforting to know my money is in good hands with ITP Partners. Ticket here for ITP Partners. Jacksonville guys taking care of my Jacksonville money. I'll admit it, I don't understand a ton about the economy, higher interest rates, 401ks, but I do know as I move closer to retirement, I continue to watch my money grow. Thanks to Chris Bryan, Jeff Hartman, Reagan Wright, Dan Abel, and Reed Wingate. Get in the game, guys. ITP Partners, always there to help. For more info, Chris at ITPPartners.com or call 904-312-9751.
Leon Searcy here, Jaguar legend and three-time national champion. Are you ready to elevate your game and dominate on the gridiron? Our elite offensive line camp is designed for young athletes who aspire to push their limits, refine their skills, and become the very best. It's called the Lineman Life. Sunday, April 14th, D1 training on Beach Boulevard. Whether you are aiming to make a starting lineup or a college scholarship, this camp is for you. Spots are limited, so secure your spot now. Go to eventbrite.com, the Lineman Life, offensive line camp. Enter promo code 1010 and get $25 off. Greatness awaits.
Pull up a chair at the table for some Saturday afternoon sports talk with Compton and Company.
So you want to talk about this or what?
Join Compton and Company noon to 2 Saturdays for more conversation about the teams you care about most.
I have questions. I need answers.
On 1010XL.
Daily's Dash is not only your Jaguars game day stop, but a great place to grab a meal any day of the week.
To honor the Jags and the fans, we've crafted the Duval sub. The Duval comes with freshly sliced turkey, ham, melted cheddar, and habanero jack cheese, topped with crisp lettuce, fresh tomatoes, and a double portion of our secret sauce, all served on a fresh roll. Come by your Locals Daily Dash today to get your delicious Duval sub. Daily's is the official convenience store sponsor of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
I'm with Greg from Cycles of Jacksonville. I know Honda, they're so cool on the road and off the road, but guess what? Tell them about them being on the water.
There is an all-new Honda boat coming out. We went out and partnered with Scout, who's been making the finest hulls in the business for years. They're fuel-efficient, dynamic, and class-leading.
So Honda is in the boat business, and you will see boats coming to Cycles of Jacksonville soon.
We will have them in the spring, ready to go.
CyclesofJacksonville.com. Keep track of all of it. Find them on Atlantic near Regency.
Baloo for Shenactory Chiropractic. They've helped me get rid of my headaches and pain in my neck and back. Are you suffering from an auto accident? What about TMJ pain? Headaches associated with jaw clenching, grinding of the teeth, or stress-related disorders? Shenactory Chiropractic has a physical therapist on staff for rehabilitation, quality chiropractic care, dry needling, massage, and acupuncture. Call 743-6700. Or go to ShenactoryDC.com.
Hacker here, and most of us have a closet full of clothes ranging in sizes, keeping around the smaller ones for when we plan to fit into them again. If you told me just a month ago I'd already be wearing a full shirt size smaller, I'd laugh. But thanks to Awaken 180, dropping 35 pounds in just 4 weeks, this guy has already dropped a full shirt size. Notches on my belt, too. Crazy results, and I'm just getting started. The best part? I'm not on this journey alone. My Awaken 180 coach, Kate, is there whenever I need her. I've tried other programs before, but I have never received the kind of results and support I'm getting with Awaken 180. 35 pounds in 4 weeks, and I feel better than I have in years. What's stopping you? Do what Mike Dempsey, Matt Hayes, and I did. Make the call to Awaken 180, 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800, or online at Awaken180WeightLoss.com.
Friday on The Franchi Show, tune in for the House Call segment brought to you by Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute Rehab. Join the discussion as a JOI expert tells us about baseball and softball injuries. JOI, where the pros go.
Are you a meat lover searching for quality cuts? Southern Steer Butcher uses a vacuum tumbler to marinate and tenderize our chicken and world-famous steak tips.
Now open in Ortega. For tasty tips and juicy breasts, choose Southern Steer Butcher.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Now, more Jaguars today on 1010XL.
All right, about 20 minutes away from John Shipley of Jaguar Report joining the fellas here on Jaguars Today. Mike Dempsey, Tony Smith, Dylan Denmark, Pockets, last day of the week. Big track events going down this week. ET will be in tomorrow. Had pseudo-track events going on at LSU's Pro Day yesterday, right?
Nice transition.
Thank you. Malik Nabers ran a 4.33 or 4.32 40 on his best effort, and then I guess had a phone attached to his hand, and when he saw the 4.32, he tweeted out 4.28. Correct it, like he knows like his internal body clock knows what he was running. I guess so. Anyway,
we all know you're fast, man.
You're fast, dude. 4.32, 4.28. I don't think it's gonna change anything, quite frankly. But whatever, you're plenty fast. Had a good workout. All that broad jump was like 10.9, which was fine. The vertical was 42 inches, which is
my goodness,
son. Like, if you really have never seen somebody with that kind of feet,
that is nuts.
I'm telling you, if you've never been around an athlete that can do that and like played any sport with somebody that's got that kind of explosiveness, man, it's something else. It's like they're not human.
No,
you know, and you can jump like that, and I mean, it would have been, I think, the sixth best jump at
the combine
at any position, I believe is what they said. And he was within like an inch or a half inch of all the top guys. It's pretty good. I mean, you're not always trying to high point a ball, but and I don't even look at it like, oh, he can jump over this defensive back. I mean, yes, it's indicative that you can jump over a lot of people, but it's just general explosive ability in that lower body.
It's an example of an athlete being a supreme athlete. Like, that dude is a freak of an athlete, that he can do all the things that he can do, and it's all in one person, that they can do all the things that he can physically do on a football field. Yeah, it's impressive. I don't know how you wouldn't walk away from that. Can jump 3.5 feet in the air.
Right, and he puts up big numbers, and he played at the big program, and the film is there, and he was already considered a top prospect. So all you got to do is go out there and reconfirm that if you're in his position.
And he
did. Brian Thomas did, I guess, some of the on-field catching drills, but didn't, you know, participate in, like, the speed and explosiveness drills, because he did his at the combine, ran a 4.33. So they're identical, basically, in terms of top-end speed, at least in shorts running a 40-yard dash.
Like, Neighbors and Daniels didn't work out at the combine. So their first workout with everyone seeing what they were doing was yesterday.
Right.
And Thomas had worked out at the combine, so he said, look, I ran 4.33.
A couple weeks ago.
Yeah. Y'all know how fast I am. Right. So he didn't do any of that stuff that these guys were doing.
You got to run one fast 40, man.
Yeah.
And if you run a slow one at the combine, you run a fast one at your pro day, people are like, well, something happened at the combine.
Yeah.
This is what he's capable
of doing.
Who's
timing that one?
Right. Or you know, you slipped or whatever. You know, you're wearing the wrong shoe. I don't know. You know, as far as Jaden Daniels goes, we know he's going high, whether he goes 2, 3, whatever.
Yeah.
Doesn't really matter. As long as he goes ahead of the Jags. By the way, Charles Davis with a new mock at NFL.com. 5 quarterbacks in the top 16 and a 6th at 19. Don't they feel the need to trade up a little bit to make sure that they get their man? I kind of feel like that would be the case.
Come and get him.
Penix going at 16 and Bo Nix at 19, according to Charles Davis. But I thought really the interesting thing, because we know the Jags, we suspect at least that they should have a decent amount of interest in Brian Thomas when we're looking at these skill position guys. By the way, brand new tight end for the Jaguars.
Mm-hmm.
See this one?
I did.
Josiah DeGuara. DeGuara. I'm not sure.
There's something.
Yes. former Packer tight end signing a 1-year deal with the Jags. It's coming down, according to Jordan Schultz moments ago. Pockets brought that to my attention. Mm-hmm. He's a big fan of the face paint, is what he is as well. Demetrius Harvey tweeting about that as well from from Jaguar Report. He might have been the first source in that one. So
third
there you
round
go.
Pick in 2020 out of Cincinnati, there to Green Bay, and you know he's been the second, third tight end.
Yeah, he's a depth guy.
Yeah,
that's what he is. Now, what he may be, Tony, is he may be a special team piece, right? Because now
they're going to
talk about
that.
Instead of small, speedy guys running down the field, they're talking about tight ends, safeties, linebackers being more of what you're going to be looking for in terms of...
It's kind of a weird position, you know, for NFL teams to figure out exactly how they want to even handle that from a roster perspective, right? Because you're going to... Traditionally, it has been, you know, secondary players that have been... They got to be fast enough to get downfield and do the job, right? It's why Daniel Thomas...
Wide receivers as well.
Right, like that kind of thing. It's like those players have been the coverage guys and that, you know, like that's what they've been asked to do. Well, it's different now. It's not that you can't have any of those guys on the field, but there's going to be much more size. It's going to be a little bit more important when it comes to kickoff returns, especially. Like, punts are punts.
And it's not about racing down the field. You're already going to be there.
Like, the punts are the same thing. You know, the value that Daniel Thomas brings as a gunner, he still brings as a gunner, right, when you're on punt coverage for your football team. But what is his role on kickoff coverage now? I don't know.
Yeah.
You know, that's up for debate exactly how they want to handle this. And so, yeah, big bodies are going to be at a premium.
So I'm suspecting that's got a tie-in to that.
I can't imagine it wouldn't.
Would be my suspicion there. So Josiah DeGuara, newest Jacksonville Jaguar as of a few moments ago. But back to the LSU
he was playing
pro day here.
A lot of special teams, by the way, for Green Bay the last
I'm sure
years.
That's what this move is, you know, and good for that. Like, hey, Pittsburgh reacted right away. Look, the Jags may have anticipated it. Either way, the Jags needed a return man.
They did.
And they got Duvernay, who's a really good return guy. Whether they signed it before or after the rule change wouldn't matter, right? I mean, but clearly the day of, Pittsburgh goes out there and says, all right, Cordarrelle Patterson, let's go. This is going to be more important. Now that we know we're going to give you this money and you're going to start seeing some of these signings that of guys that you don't recognize and you think, oh, maybe that's just normal post first wave of free agency stuff, and some of it will be,
yeah.
But some of it will be with an eye towards guys that fit these newly configured roles.
And as we were discussing briefly on the show yesterday, not every team in the league is going to have a Tyreek Hill that they can now think about being, well, that's our returner now.
Yeah.
Right? Like, not every team has that. Jacksonville doesn't have that. Right? Like, it's not like, well, we got a guy that we were protecting from having to do that because of how much he means to us as a wide receiver. Right? Like, Jacksonville doesn't have that guy. They got DuVernay, who's shown that whatever the situation is in returning, he's as good as there is in the league to this point, you know, for the last 3, 4, 5 years. So that makes sense to have that kind of guy on the roster, especially when you don't have a guy that you've been protecting from doing that kind of thing on the return game thing. So DuVernay makes a lot of sense for the Jaguars to sign.
All right, so that happened. Let's get back to this. I just want to touch on something that went down yesterday with the LSU, right?
Yeah.
Malik Nabers, like, you get to go in, you can have visits with these guys if you set things up ahead. And some, you know, like, I don't think Caleb Williams did any visits until after he had his throwing session, I think is how he was doing it. Maybe mm-hmm. Jaden Daniels had a few beforehand. Whatever. You do it how you want to do it. But I did find it interesting that of the teams that met with Malik Nabers before the LSU Pro Day, the Jags were one of them. Well, sure, they're just doing their due diligence. Well, what does that even mean? Due diligence on what? In case we're in position when he becomes a free agent in 5 years, that we have a good scouting report, you know, like right. In case he slips, sure. But most teams are not going to do that because they know where Malik Nabers figures into the draft hierarchy this year. That, like, the craziest scenarios have him lasting maybe to the 9th pick, right? Where Roma Dunze is often mocked, but some people say that there are teams that like Dunze more than Nabers. Well, there are teams that apparently like Nabers more than Harrison in this deal. So, not many people suspect he's going to get out of the top 6 picks, right? The Giants could take him at 6. The Chargers could take him at 5. The Cardinals could even take him at 4. Whatever the case may be. So, all the teams that met with Nabers yesterday, with the exception of Jacksonville, have a top 10 pick?
Yeah.
Is this just a simple matter of, I don't know, kicking the tires and seeing what he's made of? Because the overwhelming likelihood is you're not going to be able to draft. And we looked at what it would take to get up to, like, the 4th pick in the draft, Tone.
Yeah.
It's like 2 firsts and a 2nd, right? This year's 1st, this year's 2nd, next year's 1st.
I think it is – they're not going to have him in for one of those 30 visits, right? Like, I think they were beyond the pale. They're not going to be able to do that kind of thing. So if we're going to talk to him, we got to talk to him now. Right, like, this is our opportunity to go talk to him. So it makes sense to do it, and maybe it does indicate that they are willing to be more aggressive and going up for a top-of-the-depth-chart wide receiver than we've thought they might be for the last several weeks. Maybe it does indicate that kind of thing. The cost would be big, right? To go up and get that guy, you're likely talking about your 1st and 2nd-round pick this year and your 1st next year.
Well, to go all the way up to assure yourself. Now, if a guy slides to 9, we looked at the chart
right.
that Pro Football Reference is using right now, and it's the Jags' 1st and 2nd pick compared to the 9th pick. The Jags' 2 picks are like a 6th-rounder in value greater
yes.
than what they're acquiring. So theoretically, like, the 9th pick in the draft plus a 6th-rounder, yeah. The thing is, Chicago has the 9th pick. They don't have a pick after the 4th round,
yeah.
but you could do a 2025 pick,
absolutely,
whatever.
Yeah.
So you could, if you were willing to do it, you say, well, wait a minute. If you're not willing to give up a 1st to sign Brandon Ayuk, what's the difference? Ayuk's proven he is, but he was also proven that he's going to get $20-plus million a year.
Yeah.
You know, the guy, again, the guy you get at 9, you'll afford the entire first 4 years of his contract.
Yeah.
For less than you'll pay Brandon Ayuk for 1.
Yeah, I think it's a
visit. On a new deal.
Right. I think it's a visit with a player that likely in the end means nothing. But I have no problem with this team with the needs that they have to find that top of the depth chart wider, at least exploring the options. Right?
Right, but they're not the only team in this position, I guess is my point, is that I'd have no problem with it. I'd have no problem if 17 other teams outside the top 10
decided to do it.
I really do think
it might indicate that they're willing to be more aggressive to make it happen than we may have thought they
right,
were willing to be.
Let's know what this guy's about. And in case it did go this way,
if the opportunity rises, we want to know what we're getting.
Right.
Right? Like, and I think that's a good way to do business from that perspective.
And you're sitting there, you're Malik Nabers. If let's say Harrison does go 4, you're thinking the next 2 teams are Los Angeles and New York.
Mm-hmm.
Those are pretty big markets to become a star in, right?
Sure.
Hey, how do you feel if Jacksonville comes? You know what I mean? Not that he has the final say, and who drafts him.
Sure.
But you want –
it's not foolish to
like
ask.
Mike Tomlin says, yeah. You know, you want volunteers, not hostages, right?
Yeah.
And to a large degree, I agree with that, particularly before you take a guy. If you know he's going to be a problem before he comes here. I'm not suggesting Malik Nabers is a problem in any way, shape, or form. I don't know the guy mm-hmm. from Adam. I'm just saying, you know
– or to find out about his teammate.
Maybe a little bit.
You
but
know,
to
some degree. But I don't think that's what that meeting was about.
Right.
Like, I think it was about him, and the Jags have some level of interest in landing him.
And there are better ways to find out about your teammate, I think, because I think for the most part, Malik Nabers is going to have Brian Thomas's back and vice versa, right? They're probably very tight.
I would assume.
Right? They're in the same room. They're playing together. They're both excelling. They're both seen as first-round picks. They're probably really tight is my guess.
Did they meet
anyway.
With Thomas at the combine? I don't remember.
I don't either, but I would suspect that they did. But I don't know that. I don't have a full list in front of me. We'll check that out on the break, mm-hmm. and we'll come back with John Shipley, and let's see if we can't endeavor to have that info for you on the other side. I just, again, may mean nothing in the grand scheme of things, mm-hmm. and Malik Nabers goes fifth to the Chargers and never looks back, right? But no other team decided to do it. And, you know, you could say due diligence. And so is Trent Baalke just better at due diligence than every other team outside the top 10? Right? You know, seriously, right? Like, what are we saying here exactly?
I'm glad that he's doing the due diligence.
Is there no other team out there, though, that would be interested in learning about what makes Malik Nabers tick? I think most teams are telling you by not seeking out those face-to-face meetings mm-hmm. that we know – we're not likely to get him, and by the time we're likely to get him, we're going to know plenty about him after he plays his rookie deal
Thomas
out in the National Football
League.
Thomas
did meet with the Jags
at the combine. I would have suspected that would have been the case. You have the full list?
I do not. No.
All right. We'll see if we can grab that for you and maybe get into that in an hour or two. Let's welcome in John Shipley from Jaguar Report coming up next. How does he feel about how things will play out between the Jags and Josh Allen? Is there anything to the Jags maybe making a big strike up the board to grab a wide out, a top target for Trevor Lawrence, and other draft-related issues 4 weeks out from round one of the NFL draft. You're listening to the Jaguars Today. Big Ship on the other side on 1010XL, 92.5 FM.
Jaguars Today.
Jaguars Today.
From the JOI Studios at 1010XL.
Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute.
Where the pros go. 1010XL takes you inside the program director's office with Dan and Jeff.
I think you're not suited for this job.
Mornings.
In addition to being incompetent, you threaten my reputation, and not just today.
On 1010XL.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Did you hear what's happening? Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet are spring cleaning. New inventory on the ground means we need to make more room. Take advantage of huge savings on thousands of vehicles priced to sell. New and pre-owned prices have been reduced, and all sales associates have been instructed to give maximum value on all trades. But you better hurry. The best deals go first. Head to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine
or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville to take advantage of our spring cleaning sale.
We're here to wow you.
Discover the timeless beauty of stone with Art of Natural Stone, offering an extensive selection of products. They cater to every design aesthetic. And not just a supplier, they also provide the installation. Skilled craftsmen ensure a flawless finish every time with Art of Natural Stone. You receive not just a product, but an inviting welcome home experience. So embrace the elegance of your own yard this year with artofnaturalstone.com. Open to the public on Phillips Highway and on Beach Boulevard.
How's Wingstop sound? Crispy, juicy, classic wings. Made to order, cooked to perfection. And sauced and tossed in those 11 soul-satisfying flavors. Paired with hand-cut seasoned fries, house-made honey mustard, blue cheese, or signature Wingstop ranch. And, of course, spicy Cajun fried corn. I think you've heard enough. Get your flavor delivered at Wingstop.com.
Ever wonder how you can transform your living spaces into captivating works of art? At First Coast Lighting and Fans, they offer a huge selection of high-quality products to match your desire for elegance, quality, and uniqueness. Visit their showroom on Phillips Highway at The Avenues and step into a world of quality without compromise. Discover the difference that locally owned expertise makes and let them help you experience the transformation from average to extraordinary. At First Coast Lighting and Fans.
K
Get recruiting tips and advice from area coaches, pros, athletes, and their parents.
So you gotta up your game.
Plus, better ways to train as B3 Better brings you the Amateur's Edge Show. Saturday from 11 to noon on 1010XL.
Hi, I'm Sean Monahan from Monahan Jewelers in Atlantic Beach. Since 1977, we've been Jacksonville's family jeweler, where our true specialty is engagement rings and custom jewelry design. And now, buy your diamond engagement ring at Monahan's and get any diamond wedding band and men's wedding bands for 50% off. Come in and be treated like family for one of the most important purchases of your life. Buy your diamond engagement ring right now at Monahan's and get any diamond wedding band and gents band for 50% off. Come to Monahan Jewelers in Atlantic Beach or book an appointment at monahanjewelry.com.
Need protection? Call Craig and Christine Kaprosky at Goosehead Insurance. The Kaproskys are a husband and wife team committed to finding you the right coverage at the right price in just a few short minutes. For home, auto, flood, or specialty insurance, Craig and Christine Kaprosky are the answer. Craig.Kaprosky at Goosehead.com.
Your AC's broke. It ain't no joke. Call Florida Home AC. Florida Home AC. Florida Home AC. Florida Home AC. FloridaHomeAC.com.
Let's go!
Let's go!
Don't miss the Jacksonville Sharks' first home game against the IFL defending champion Bay Area Panthers next Saturday, April 6th, at the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena, kickoff 7 p.m. Let's go! Let's show them what we got.
Let's go!
Tickets as low as $15. You can't find Saturday family affordable fun anywhere else. Call 904-621-0700 or go to jacksharks.com. Dust off your boots, grab your cowboy hat for Western night. Join us at 5 p.m. for Shark Fest, every home game located outside the arena for our pre-game party. Help us rock the tank as we roll out the 2023 NAL Championship Band.
Let's go!
Don't miss opening night of the season next Saturday, April 6th, 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena. Be a part of indoor football fun and exciting non-stop action. For tickets as low as $15, call 904-621-0700. Don't forget your cowboy hats.
Let's go!
Good friends and great memories. Everybody hopes to have a bunch of them. The best way to make more is when you're out for a good time, keep an eye on your friends and make sure everyone gets home safe. Anheuser-Busch reminding you to always drink responsibly.
This is Hayes Carline for First Florida Credit Union. I bank with First Florida Credit Union because I trust them. I can always count on them when it comes to the vast services they provide. First Florida Credit Union was voted Best Bank in the 2023 Best of Bold City Community Choice Awards, and it's easy to see why. I go to the branch off 210 in St. Johns County and the new Durbin location, but they have 10 branches in the Jacksonville area. You need to be banking with First Florida Credit Union. They're enriching people every day. Federally insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Opportunity Lender.
At the First Coast YMCA, you'll find much more than just a gym. We offer many ways to help you be active, reach weight loss goals, and find your inner strength while you connect with your community. Family memberships at the Y include unlimited group exercise classes, childcare while you work out, and youth sports participation. It's easy to join the Y and affordable for all. Plus, the Y is a great place to meet a new circle of friends. Visit the Y near you or online at fcymca.org.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line. Now, more Jaguars today on 1010XL.
All right, John Shipley, Jaguar Report. The time's a-wasting. The days are drawing near for the NFL draft. 28 days away from round one. We got Big Ship here with us from Jaguar Report this morning. Good morning, John. How are you, sir? What's going on, buddy?
None, man. Just, you know, enjoying this little bit of break in the offseason before craziness starts up again.
Yeah, so how was the honeymoon?
It was good. It was good. It was nice to unplug it a little bit. I didn't get to unplug completely, but it was nice to get away. Definitely an adjustment getting back, feet on soil over here.
All right. Well, we are ready to dive into it. We're 4 weeks out, you know, and we're all trying to read the tea leaves, John. And noticed yesterday, and maybe there's nothing to it, you know, but I did find it interesting that the Jags made time to meet individually with Malik Nabers prior to the LSU Pro Day when they were the only team with a pick outside the top 10 to do that. Is this just them trying to get a book on him, get a little bit of feel? Because it would seem implausible that they're going to move up high enough to go where he's projected to go. Is this a move that in case he slides further in the top 10, they might be able to pounce? Or are they just curious? How do you read something like this?
Yeah, I think it's just due diligence, just like them meeting with Rome Odunze at the combine was due diligence. You know, you have to plan for every single scenario. So while it seems unlikely that Neighbors falls very far, you know, down the top 10, maybe he does. You know, maybe there's a scenario where four quarterbacks go early. Then you see, you know, Marvin Harrison to Arizona, a couple offensive tackles, Dallas turn into Atlanta. All of a sudden, there's a chance a guy like Neighbors or a guy like Odunze is there at number 9 or number 10. So if that scenario happens, I think that, you know, you have to have it planned for. You can't just go into a draft, you know, assuming there's no way you get this guy, so you don't do any homework on him. You have to plan for every scenario. And that's how I see it. I think they obviously would be interested in a guy like Malik Neighbors. He's, you know, a fantastic prospect. So just doing a due diligence, getting to know him in case, you know, a potential scenario pops up like that.
Look, to get to 9 or 10, according to most of the charts that are out there, the Jags would have to give up the 17th pick and their second rounder this year. That's rough value. You might get a little late pick coming back your way. Do you think there's a player they would do that for in this year's draft, package both of their top two picks just for that one guy?
That's tough for me to see because, on one hand, you know, us looking from the outside in, it seems like, you know, they have a lot of holes. You know, I personally believe that they still have, you know, a number of holes that they need to fill in the draft. But to them, I mean, you've heard them say, you know, before a few times this offseason that they feel like, you know, they're right there. They don't feel like they're that far away. They finished 9-8, et cetera. They feel like they need to finish better. So maybe they do think that they're, you know, that one player away from getting over the hump. If they thought that internally, that really wouldn't surprise me. The package I keep coming back to is a couple years ago. This isn't the same scenario as the Jags moving 17-9 or 17-10. But a few years ago, the Saints moved from 16-11, and they only had to give up 16, 98, and 120. So that's the first, the third, and the fourth. If there's a scenario where a guy's falling to 11 or 12, I would pull the trigger on that kind of package immediately.
With all that being said, and you know, we are 4 weeks away from the first round of the NFL draft, do you feel right now like the more likely scenario is that the Jags were to move up or down in the draft if they were to go either way?
That's a tough one. I'd say, honestly, probably move down. You know, they gave up the pick for Mac Jones. They lost, obviously, the third rounder for Calvin Ridley. You would think they'd want to maybe recoup those in a way, but if one of the receivers falls, you know, Neighbors or Odunze, I think it'd be Odunze because you see all these reports of teams being split between Harrison and Neighbors. You don't see Odunze in there very often, even though I personally think he's the second best receiver in the class. I could see them making a move for one of the big receivers if they fall, or maybe, you know, they move up to, say, number 12 to try to jump the Colts for a quarterback. But ultimately, I think it's probably more likely they move back.
Yeah, that's the thing, right? Like, there are a bunch of corners where we go, oh, they could have this corner, they could have that corner. Well, they're going to like certain corners. They're not going to like other ones, right? And they're going to look for certain traits and all those kind of things. So, John, at this point, when you talk about positions that they might go after in the first round, I think wide receiver and cornerback are well discussed at this point, right? Nobody's going to be surprised.
Oh, yeah.
Should defensive tackle still be in consideration? Should edge be in consideration? What else should be on the board? Maybe offensive line. What else should be in play in the first round?
I struggle with defensive tackle just because we've seen throughout, you know, Trent Baalke's tenure as Jaguars general manager and even back to his tenure as the 49ers general manager, normally in the first round, he's looking for an immediate impact guy, somebody who can step in right away and really play a starter's level role. I'm not sure you can get that at defensive tackle, even if Byron Murphy very well could be the best player available. Just because, you know, obviously Eric Armstead, you know, Devon Hamilton, Roy Robson Harris, it'd be harder to find, you know, starter level snaps for that guy. Offensive line would be honestly interesting to me because there's a good chance that just because of the strength of this draft class, that the best player available at that pick is an offensive lineman, likely somebody who can play inside, outside. With Cam Robinson and Walker Little both on contract years, I think it would make sense. But again, I'm not sure if they want to use the 17th overall pick on a guy who will be, you know, a backup in year one. And then edge, I personally think it's always a good idea to stock up on pass rushers. I think taking one in the top 100 almost annually would be a good idea. But we saw the trade deadline last year. They were looking for backups, not starters. I just struggle, again, to marry the fact that they don't want a guy who will come in and take snaps from Trayvon to them taking a guy at 17 overall. I mocked them an edge often last year. I feel like I learned from that mistake. I'm not going to do it much this year.
They haven't done anything with Cam Robinson's contract to this point. Do you think they'd be willing, if they were going to spend the number 17 pick on an offensive tackle, do you think they'd be willing at that point to move on from Cam Robinson and have the rookie start?
I think it'd make a lot of sense to flow either him or Walker Little as trade pieces. I think, you know, you don't get many offensive tackles, especially left tackles, with starting experience who are on the trade market very often. So I think either one of those pieces would be, you know, extremely potentially valuable. I think Cam Robinson may be a little tougher to move just because I'm not sure how many teams would want to take on, you know, that big of a cap hit in year one. Maybe the Jags would take on some of it. But I think even, you know, potentially trading a guy like Walker Little in the last year of his deal, maybe you can get a third or a fourth pick for that kind of guy.
Interesting. We'll see. What? Give me a percent likelihood that an offensive lineman gets moved by this team in direct relation to what they do in the draft.
I'll go 15%.
15, okay. I thought like 20 maybe. So, yeah. We're in the same kind of area. All right, well, let's get back to defensive end here for a second. So we're asking folks today. I was a little surprised Mike DiRocco came on with us from ESPN on Monday and thought there's at least a decent chance that the Jags get a deal done with Josh Allen by the draft, which surprised me. That's 4 weeks away. Whether it's the draft, we know that July 15th is the deadline for getting it done this offseason. What do you think? Where are you on that, on the extension getting done? And they certainly have a better feel for whether it will get done or not, John. And how might that impact? Like, they did meet with a guy like Jared Verse at the combine. And maybe, again, that's due diligence. But if he's there at 17 and negotiations are going nowhere with Josh Allen, could that factor into the decision?
I think it potentially could. I mean, you saw this exact scenario with the Jags when they picked Josh Allen, you know. At the same time, you know, Yannick Ngakoue was looking for a new deal. Obviously, he was going back and forth with the franchise. And then they drafted a guy to essentially replace him. Now, it's not like an apples-to-apples comparison because, obviously, Josh Allen's a different level of player. It's a different situation, different front office, et cetera. But we've seen that kind of scenario play out. So it wouldn't surprise me. It would be kind of a leverage play by the Jaguars. The only thing is you better hope that guy is as good as Josh Allen. You know, they knew Josh Allen would be as good as Yannick Ngakoue because Ngakoue, for as productive as a pass rusher as he was, he never really had that three-down potential that Allen showed, even as a rookie. So, if you take a guy, you better hope he develops into something similar to Allen. You know, it's like the, you know, old joke, it's a mystery box. You know, it can be anything. He can even be Josh Allen. Well, you already have Josh Allen, so, you know.
Yeah, Mike and I have already reacted here in the last 15 minutes to the team signing Josiah DeGuara and what that might actually mean from a special teams perspective. It does feel like there's more of an emphasis on what the heck does kick coverage look like for football teams going into this season with the new kickoff rule. What have your reaction been to the new kickoff rule being instated?
I personally, I'm in favor of the rule. I think, you know, they've made Peterson himself said at the owners' meeting that, you know, out of like 13 kickoffs in the Super Bowl, none were returned. So I think it's a good way to get kickoffs back in the sport, you know, eliminate touchbacks. As somebody who works in the press box, the kickoffs were a time for us to kind of get up, stretch our legs, and get a drink. So we're going to have to find a different time for that. But I think it's a good move ultimately. And, you know, for the Jags, they sign a guy like Devin Duvernay. You know, maybe now it is the time to, you know, start investing in returners again now with this, you know, return change, because it does, you know, give you a little bit of a step when you have somebody explosive back there. And also maybe it can give you a way to utilize other players. I mean, maybe, you know, even a guy like Tank Bigsby could potentially be used as a kick returner under these new rules. It just, I think, gives you more flexibility overall with your roster.
John, the boys in Vegas set the over-under win total for the Jags at 8.5 this year, right smack in the middle of those 17 games they'll be playing. So, do you think that's a fair kind of bar, and which side of the bar do you suspect the Jags fall on as of today?
I think it's probably fair just based on how last season ended. And, you know, obviously the big ticket free agent for the Jaguars leaving for a division rival probably hurts them, you know, in terms of public perception with their offseason, et cetera, stuff like that. So I think it's probably fair. I don't, you know, Jaguars, they've won 9 games in each of the last 2 years. So I don't think they can, you know, really say that they're getting discriminated against or anything like that. I'd go over. I'm not super confident in it, and it really doesn't have much to do with the Jags. It has to do with the AFC South looks like it's going to be as competitive this upcoming year as it's been in a long, long time. Like even the Titans, who many are painting as, you know, going to be the fourth place finisher, they look significantly improved from just a year ago. You know, the Colts are getting Anthony Richardson back. You know, they obviously still have their pieces when they went 9-8 with Gardner Minshew, you know, mostly under center. The Houston Texans are adding guys and are also, you know, CJ Stroud's entering year two. So I think the AFC South's going to be one of the toughest divisions in football this year. So I'd go over, but I'm not super confident.
It certainly sounds like they're going to be playing more four down linemen in the defense this year. They've played plenty of that, you know, the last couple of years. But it does sound like they're going to be playing more of that. Who do you think is the odd man out between Hamilton and Roy Robertson-Harris when they are playing that, if they're playing that as their base?
I think it's got to be Robertson-Harris. If you look at the Jaguars roster, they don't have many true nose tackles on the roster. It's basically Devon Hamilton and, you know, maybe Jeremiah Ledbetter. So I think in an ideal scenario, you know, Devon Hamilton comes back 100% from last year's health issues, and he slots in there next to Armstead, and it gives you, you know, a lot of balance throughout the line. You have the run stuff where you have somebody who can shoot the gaps, and then you have the two edge guys and Josh Allen and Trayvon Walker. I think that makes the most sense. But when it gets to third down, you know, the pass rush formations, I think then it makes sense for Robinson Harris to come in, and you have your 2-3 techniques, and you kind of spread things out.
All right, Ship, what are you working on now between now and April's NFL draft? Like, what's your focus for the next 4 weeks?
It's an interesting time period for me. That's about it, as much as I can say. I encourage people to go out and read about some stuff that's going on, but that's about as much as I can say.
It's all right.
Interesting time period.
All right. We understand, and you're limited, but we encourage folks to continue to follow you on social media for all the latest at @John_Shipley. You know you're always welcome to talk Jags on this program, and we'll be inviting you back on a regular basis, of course, not only before the NFL draft, but well beyond. But keep up the good work, brother. We're all in your corner, and we know things will ultimately work out in your favor.
Thanks, fellas. I really appreciate it.
All right, buddy. There he goes. John Shipley with Jaguar Report, who does a phenomenal job covering your team on a daily basis, along with several other really bright people in this market, including our own Mia O'Brien and Hayes Carlion. All right, so there you go. Some thoughts from Ship on that. Due diligence, again, I get it. But they're the only one outside the top 10 doing that due diligence mm-hmm. right now. So I do think it is an indicator, like you said, Tony, if the conditions are right, they clearly want a top of the depth chart wide receiver. Whether they feel like Brian Thomas can be that, I don't know. But I think most people feel like Malik Nabers, Roma Dunze, will be that or can potentially be that.
Sure.
So what is that range and how comfortable are they and how do they feel about, like, do they feel like John suggests they might, that maybe we do have more answers here and we do feel more confident about this than you do? And, you know, what do people complain about last year? Well, you drafted in the second and third round guys that really weren't going to make a big impact in their first year. You know, you acted like this team was built. Well, for all the people saying, hey, you got to protect Trevor, if you draft an offensive lineman, there's a good chance that that guy's impact will not be felt until 2025.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I'm not opposed to doing it, by the way, because you have to balance the immediate with the shorter and the longer term and how you're constructing a football team.
Yeah.
You know, and that takes into account how much money you're spending at various positions and all these different things. So I think at this point, though, right, when you look at corner, wide receiver, defensive line, offensive line, I mean, that wipes out a lot of positions right there. But we're going to be shocked. I think, honestly, probably the great likelihood is wide receiver cornerback mm-hmm. is over 50% likelihood to be one of those
Agreed.
Picks. And those other three positions or position groups account for all but the tiniest, less than 1% of the likelihood.
Yeah, the Brock Bowers likelihood.
Something like, and even right. that I think is extremely unlikely. Even if he's sitting there,
yeah.
I just don't see Brock Bowers as being a good use of resources for this football team. I mean, we got Josiah DeGuara now. Has anyone heard about that? The tight end room is loaded, Tony. Mm-hmm. I get it. Likely a special team signing. All right, Big Cat Country has put together a pretty good list of the players and the prospects that the Jags have visited with in various capacities, including at the combine. So we'll go off that, and I've got some other sources I found out there that have a few more names we can add to the list. So I'm just really focusing on, again, the positions that they are focusing on, and you will see that there's a lot in the secondary and a lot going on as well at wide receiver. And according to at least Walter Football, they met with Bo Nix. Why would they meet with Bo Nix?
I don't know.
That's, I mean, that to me is just, is he going to be available at 17? Yeah. So, I mean, that just seems incredibly, incredibly odd if that, in fact, happened the way it was reported to have happened. So, hour two coming up, 641-1010. If you want to get in on the All-Pro Roofing phone lines, if you've got any reaction to anything John Shipley had to say, you're welcome to do that as well. This is Jaguars Today on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Jaguars Today.
From the JOI Studios at 1010XL. Get Florida Gators play-by-play on 1010XL.
It's a weekend of Easter baseball in the swamp. Florida, Mississippi State. Friday night, Saturday night, and Sunday at 1 on 1010 AM.
Top Dog Tavern is your gathering place for family and friends, offering something for everyone. Want a delicious meal served with a smile? We have you covered. Shareable appetizers, hot and crispy wings, juicy tavern burgers, fresh salads, plus a large craft beer selection. And there is nowhere better to watch all the big games than on our multiple TVs. Enjoy great food, cold drinks, and good times at Top Dog Tavern, located in Bartram Park off Old St. Augustine Road.
Did you know Prime Roofing manufactures, fabricates, and installs their metal roofs? If you're thinking about a metal roof, think Prime Roofing. Schedule an estimate today at PrimeRoofingFL.com. That's PrimeRoofingFL.com.
Hey, Boost Mobile here to help you start from scratch. Boost is giving you the chance to win incredible prizes in our latest scratch-off sweepstakes, including up to $5,000 cash. With over 7,600 prizes up for grabs, this is an opportunity you don't want to miss. For your chance to win, just head to your local participating Boost Mobile store and ask for a scratcher. It's that easy. So visit a Boost Mobile store today and get after it. Ends 3/31/24 while supplies last. No purchase necessary. Other restrictions apply. Visit your local Boost Mobile store for details.
Dave Binion here with my son Ammon, who is the air duct cleaning manager at Zero Res. So Ammon, you may notice a little rattle in my voice and some puffiness in my eyes. That's because allergy season is coming on. Can Zero Res help?
Yes, your health has a lot to do with the air you breathe. A clean and healthy home begins with clean air. At Zero Res, we can help clean the air in your home by cleaning your air ducts, cleaning the coils in your HVAC units, and fogging the system with a powerful antimicrobial that helps kill and control the growth of microorganisms in your air. We also have options for maintaining your clean air with our excellent inline air purifier and UV lights that will help keep your system clean and healthy. At Zero Res, we are more than just air duct cleaners. We're clean air specialists.
Have Zero Res air duct specialists out, and right now we'll give you $50 off your air duct cleaning, and while we're at it, we'll give you $50 off your dryer vent cleaning. Zero Res.
Spelled forward or backwards, it's the right way to clean.
C-E-R-O-R-E-C. Zero Res.
Mia here, and let me tell you about one of our area's best resorts, the Sawgrass Marriott Golf Resort and Spa. The Sawgrass Marriott is not only a great destination for a vacation, but it is also a great destination for dining on the Florida's first coast. 1912 Ocean Bar and Rooftop is now open on Ponte Vedra Boulevard, featuring Ponte Vedra's only oceanfront rooftop bar and lounge. Serving finely crafted cocktails and delectable eats, it's open daily from 4 to 10 with complimentary valet parking.
It's March basketball. That means a host of top teams will be competing for the NCAA title. When it comes to commercial painters, there's also some healthy competition out there. Jason Parker with Performance Painting. To help you know the right questions to ask any painter competing for your business this year, visit PerformancePaintingJax.com. Or if you're ready for a friendly quote, give us a call and ask about our free pressure wash promotion for your next project. Performance Painting, quality coatings applied with pride.
Performance Painting!
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free. No credit cards, no car loan, no personal loan. Hey, it's Prosser here, and Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make that happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. you can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally, hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508. That's loanpronto.com at 904-999-1508. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
Home of the Jacksonville Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
It's Kubota Orange Days, your golden chance to score a deal that will make your neighbors green with envy. Shop the year's best selection of Kubota tractors, zero-turn mowers, and utility vehicles, including the number one selling compact tractor in the USA. And get the year's best deals, like 0% APR for 84 months or up to $3,300 off L3302 tractors. Coastal Equipment on New Kings Road and in McClenny.
Coastal Equipment.
Bet on the ball game. Get your money down. Money lines, totals, and parlays. We're cashing tickets all around.
It's baseball betting season, and VSiN's MLB betting guide is a home run for bettors. Download your free special edition of the guide, featuring a betting preview of the Atlanta Braves and Tampa Bay Rays at 1010XL.com. That's 1010XL.com.
For the greenest, luscious lawn on the block, choose the local legends, Roundtree Sod. Don't just settle for ordinary. Let Roundtree Sod deliver you a picture-perfect lawn. To get a free estimate, call 7414-SOD. 7414-SOD.
This is Molly McDonald with your 1010XL Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update, brought to you by First Coast Honda Dealers. Jags quarterback Trevor Lawrence is entering the last year of his rookie contract this upcoming season. Head coach Doug Peterson states that Lawrence's work ethic is second to none, but his coaches, they want to prepare him better for the big-time moments.
He's a tremendous player, and you know, you've heard that phrase, you know, big-time players make big plays and big moments. Well, that's where he needs to get to now, and we as a staff have to get him there. And it comes down with his work ethic, which is for us second to none. I mean, he comes in, he works extremely hard in the offseason. He's a full participant in the offseason, and to me, that's so important to have your starting quarterback, the face of your franchise, in the offseason program, throwing to some of these young receivers going early, and just being able to take that next step.
High school lacrosse is on tonight as Nice and Fletcher battle it out at 7:30. You can listen to the game live on 1010 AM. It's 65 degrees at 11 o'clock. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Everything you need to know about the Jags. Jaguars today on 1010XL.
All right, Mike Dempsey, Tony Smith, Dylan Denmark here with you. Last day of the week for Pockets. Got the day off tomorrow. Going to have a big track meet over in Gainesville, and ET will be in tomorrow. According to our own Gus Logue here, who's been compiling these over at Big Cat Country.
I know him.
I know him, too. I'll holler at you, boy. If you open that door, I don't have the angle. I could probably hit him with a wadded-up something right now. He's in there toiling away here at World Headquarters. But he has gone about compiling a list of visits that the Jags have been reported to have made with various teams. So I find it interesting on here that as I'm scrolling through, and he credits, you know, where the source was, many of them are Mia O'Brien, you know, Demetrius Harvey, and in addition to some of the major ones, like Rappaport reported that they visited with Roma Dunze at the Combine. Oregon quarterback Bo Nix, via Walter Football, met with the Jaguars at the Scouting Combine, Tony. I'm like, well, that's odd, right? Yeah. That seems odd, doesn't it? I mean, he'll be available at 17, and it doesn't really matter what you value Nix at if you're not taking him, because it's what another team would value him at if they're trying to trade up and what you're at. But so I look and I'm like,
did he meet with everybody?
That, according to Walter Football, Bo Nix had 32 combine meetings.
There you go.
Literally every team met with him. Drake May met with 10. Is it that Drake May is a lock to go in a certain range and therefore other teams? Like, why would you – if you're Kansas City, why do you care about meeting with Bo Nix? If you're Houston, why would you possibly meet with Bo Nix?
Hi, Bo.
Hey, Bo.
You seem like a nice guy. Good luck in your future endeavors.
Like, you're not going to – what are you getting out of this?
Yeah.
What if he goes to your division? You've got – you only have so many of these meetings. There's only so much bandwidth. What are you meeting with a guy that's not going to –
yeah.
Impact your franchise. I don't understand. But anyway.
It's good to know he met with everybody.
Apparently
he
met with
everybody,
right?
Okay.
And so it's not like the Jags are like, hey, let's dig into Bo Nix. And I wonder what the nature of – did he have a 15-minute like one-on-one with all 32 teams?
Yeah. It's not the neighbors didn't meet with anybody else outside the top 10, right? Like it's – he met with everybody. You know?
Right. He literally met with everyone. According to Walter Football, right? Even teams that don't have a pick in the first round. Like, Houston doesn't even have a pick.
Yeah, just in case.
Just in case what?
In case, you
know. In case that gas mask bong comes out.
Yeah, you want to know how, like, the food in the city of Houston is. You might visit there every now and then.
I don't know.
I have no idea, yeah.
Whatever. So
you do you, Bo.
I'm going to leave that one kind of in its own category.
Mm-hmm.
I can't pronounce every name perfectly here, but I'll just go – through the list here of, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 guys, not counting Bo Nix, okay? Corner, defensive end, defensive tackle, defensive end, defensive end, defensive tackle, wide receiver, corner, tight end, that's Theo Johnson out of Penn State. He's more of a later round selection. Defensive end, wide receiver, corner, one interior offensive lineman, Christian Haynes out of Connecticut.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that doesn't mean that they wouldn't draft an interior offensive lineman. It just is interesting. Clearly, they're getting a sense on the corner class. And we knew that. I mean, it's obvious, you know. And we talk about Ronald Darby this week as a guy that's not guaranteed to have a starting spot that we think is going to be pretty important to this football team. This year, if they draft a corner in the first round and Ronald Darby holds him off, I'm going to be disappointed, quite frankly.
Mm-hmm.
Only a few wide receivers. But again, you don't have to meet with the guys at the combine, but it sometimes is indicative of, is this team trying to get a sense of a certain position group?
Sure.
And with all those meetings with cornerback, and quite frankly, they're a good number on the defensive line. Now, this is before you signed Eric Armstead. So things can obviously change, but they're looking at some edge rush guys in here, Tony, not just Jared Verse, but others as well. So I don't know what they think. Where are you right now? And well, you don't think they're going to get the deal done with Josh Allen by the July 15th deadline, right?
I don't know.
So you wonder how they feel. Like, we have no idea, right? Maybe they're close. Maybe they're like, hey, both sides are like, we're going to let these next 4 weeks go by. Then this is going to be our sole focus until we get it done. Or maybe it's they've exchanged some preliminary numbers and they're so far apart. Or maybe the Jags are really low. Who knows where they are?
But I don't know, yeah.
It's possible they have a sense that it doesn't get done at least by July 15th. And then it's somewhat out of your hands. Yes, you can franchise tag Josh Allen next year, but you can't do it indefinitely. And that's presuming that you don't need it for Tyson Campbell or somebody else. Or you got to... You know, as it stands right now, easiest solution. Sign Josh Allen to a long-term deal. Lower his cap hit. Give yourself more flexibility. But what if you don't get it done?
Yeah, I'm not saying that the Jaguars drafting Brenton Strange last year was because they didn't have a deal done with Evan Engram yet. But I can't say they didn't. Right? Like, I can't say that wasn't part
of
the reason why they were interested in doing that kind of thing.
Think back to last April. How many people were pounding the table for tight end? It was the first round. Tons of them.
Absolutely. Right? Like, it wasn't an uncommon thing to hear. So that was at least a factor in what they wound up doing in the draft. I'm not saying it was the deciding factor for them to draft Brenton Strange when they did, that kind of thing. But if they don't have a deal done with Josh Allen by the time the draft comes around, and they're going to have a whole lot better idea inside the building how close or far away that deal is from getting done. Right? With Josh Allen.
Yeah, they know.
And
or better than we do.
Could that have an impact on the decisions they make in April? Yeah.
What if Jared Verse is your 12th-ranked player and he's sitting there, which you can always make the case anyway. Even if you had a deal with Josh Allen, you could say, hey, look, man, We got three elite pass rushers now. Now it's up to us to get them all on the field together. Right. We'll play Trayvon inside a little bit more than we had planned on.
And with all that being said, I've made my position clear on this. I'd pay him, right? I would have paid him last year. I'd pay him now, right? Like, I am the guy who is in favor of paying Josh Allen.
I think a lot of people are,
I want him to be that guy, right? And I'm the guy that's willing to pay the 32. That doesn't bother me, right?
36? What about 36?
I'd probably be willing to do it.
40?
40's... You know, that's crazy.
I'm trying to figure out where the line is for
but,
you.
But the line isn't what it is apparently for the Jaguars at this point, right? Like, and that is clear. And my opinion on it isn't the Jaguars' opinion on it. I can accept that, right? I know there are reasons for why. We've gone through all the reasons why you may not be the one who's willing to pay him 36. Okay. I don't think it's irrational to not be willing to pay him that much money. I would be willing to pay it and not be the guy going, well, how much could Jarverse help us as the third? Like, I'm willing to pay the money to take that option to a large degree out of play, right, for the football team. But I don't think that's what's going to happen, right? Like, I think Josh Allen's going to wind up on the franchise tag this year playing when he plays for the Jacksonville Jaguars. And with that in mind, I think it does and probably should have some impact on what they do in the draft. That doesn't mean that they have to go get an edge rusher, right, at 17, but I think it brings it into play for the team at 17 more than it would if they had the long-term deal done with Josh.
Right, I'm not reaching for one like, oh, I got to fill this spot.
No.
Because you don't have to fill that spot.
It's,
but
if Jared Verse is there at 15 and I haven't signed Josh Allen, maybe I'm willing to give up a little bit of something to make that happen.
By the way, people can multitask, right? Yes. We know they can multitask. You could prepare for the draft. You could still negotiate with Josh Allen at the same time. Sorry, I mean, I refuse to
accept.
They're
allowed to do it
right?
all.
They're out there signing free agents. They signed Josiah DeGuara. I know that's not nearly as complicated. Business is being taken care of, right? Whether it's the exact order of operations you'd like. So if I'm Trent Baalke, I'm going to maybe make a push in the next 4 weeks to see how – I want to know exactly how far apart we are in this. Right?
Need to know. Yeah.
Is Josh, give me a real good sense here because I get it. Now, in terms of the deal, before the draft, I think the Jags have a little more of an advantage because, you know what, if you want that long-term – look, we can pay you the franchise tag money. We've already accounted for it. Mm-hmm. It's less than you're going to average. You're going to be the one losing money – on this deal, ultimately.
Sure.
And we can't account for that. We'd love to get you signed long-term. It helps us. It helps you. We want you here because you're a really good player. Mm-hmm. You've been a fixture since you got drafted here. But, you know, Josh, if we get the sense from you that you're keeping us at arm's length and maybe you're upset or you're just asking to, or whatever.
It's his
prerogative to act however he wants in his best interest to get a deal. I'm not suggesting that it's not. But – hey, John, just so you know, we're still going to negotiate with you, but we've got to give ourselves some options here in case you're unwilling to meet us halfway and we go sign a guy. And then doesn't mean we won't. Look, Josh, we could tag you for next year as well.
Yeah.
And it's a lot of money to tag you, but it's still less. Those 2 years combined, the Jags are going to save a bunch versus the average annual value of a new deal. So, you know, we'd love to get it done.
Yeah. Like I said, I don't think that's unreasonable.
I think if you don't draft something, if you don't add at defensive end, Josh Allen's got a little bit of leverage here. Now, look, he's still going to show up, but when is he going to show up? That's part of it, too. You want him here for training camp, don't you? I get it. He missed a lot of the voluntary.
He showed up at the mandatory.
Right, showed up for the mandatory stuff. He doesn't have to do that this year. He's not under contract.
Not until he signs whatever he signs.
Doesn't become mandatory until he puts a signature on it. So anyway, it's just, again, a lot of moving parts still going on here with the Jags offseason. Today's question of the day asks you about Josh Allen. Will the Jags get a long-term deal done with him by this year's NFL draft? That's 4 weeks from today. Will they get it done? If not then, by the July 15th franchise tag extension deadline. If not then, will they get one done next offseason? You know, either with applying another tag or before they need to, or will they just not get a long-term extension done? And somehow Josh Allen's career will end here without getting that second multi-year deal. He may go a couple tags, but that's not a long-term extension. So where are you on that? Cast your vote at MD_1010XL. Tony Smith will take us around the National Football League when we return. We're efforting Tony Pauline to join us next week. one of our favorite draft analysts, and we'll tell you who he's projecting is the 17th best player in this draft right now. It's a familiar name that we've all talked about plenty of times. We'll get into that coming up straight ahead on Jaguars Today on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Jaguars Today.
From the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute Studios.
JOI, where the pros go.
There are different kinds of family.
XL Primetime.
Joe, Matt, Leon, and Mia.
One big happy family.
But what is it about us? I mean, why all this friction between us?
Noon to three weekdays.
You put on quite a show.
On 1010XL.
What makes a Honda certified pre-owned vehicle so special? 182-point inspection, 24/7 roadside assistance, first-year free oil changes, and a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty for carefree driving backed by American Honda. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
Get ready to rock your evening with the band Be Easy at Players Grill Mandarin, a high-energy, multi-genre cover band from classic hits to chart toppers. See you at Players Grill Mandarin Friday, April 5th at 8 p.m. Players Grill, where the neighborhood meets.
There are three certainties in life: death, taxes, and if you stay in your home long enough, a new roof. Pick it here for our friends at Lockhart Roofing. Nobody better in Jacksonville. How do I know? They are a local certified Master Elite contractor, and that means they have a GAF Master Elite warranty. That's the best in the roofing industry. In this day and age, don't settle for cheaper discount roofers. Lockhart Roofing has been here for decades. They aren't going anywhere. Call my friends at Lockhart Roofing, 994-3851. That's 994-3851. Lockhart Roofing, Jacksonville's best for Jacksonville people.
The most common form of treatment for the arthritic joints is normally cortisone injections and gel shots and over-the-counter medications. And most patients have tried all of that and are still in pain.
Every day, Dr. Aaron Wolkoff, a QC Kinetics medical director, meets patients who have exhausted every method to get relief. They've been told surgery is their only option.
They want to stay away from that path, and they come to us almost as the last hope. So we're using our own body's properties to help manage pain, to help slow arthritis down, keep the patients active with no downtime, and getting back to what they enjoy doing. I mean, I love what I do.
QC Kinetics regenerative treatments from our board-certified providers help heal and restore aching joints. No surgery, harmful drugs, or downtime. Call for your free consultation today.
QC Kinetics, 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. 904-274-5522.
Get wet with Captain Kevin.
Whoa.
And remember to bring your net on the Ring Power Fishing Forecast Show.
Oh, that's a beauty.
Brought to you by Awaken 180 Weight Loss.
Look at him.
Thursday nights at 6
on 1010XL AM.
Round up a foursome of friends and test your aim to help kids succeed. It's the 6th annual Clay Shoot to support the Boys and Girls Clubs of Northeast Florida and McKenzie's Camp Deep Pond. The fun happens Thursday, May 13th at Jack's Clay Target Sports. Get your team and the Boys and Girls Club take care of the rest. Ammo, cart, plays, breakfast bites, lunch, and goodies. Proceeds benefit 56 area clubs serving over 5,200 area kids every day. Go to bgcnf.org/events.
Hey there, Jacksonville. With scorching temperatures just around the corner, it's crucial to ensure your AC is blowing nice and cool. Duck Duck Air Conditioning is here to keep you comfortable all summer long. But don't wait until the heat gets here. Our service techs are ready right now to handle any cooling issues you may have at your home or business. Call Duck Duck AC today at 904-862-6769 to schedule. That's 904-862-6769. Duck Duck Air Conditioning, online at duckduckac.com.
Lamb of God and Mastodon live. Celebrating 20 years of Ashes of the Wake and Leviathan. July 23rd, Daly's Place. With special guests, Carrie King and Malevolence. Lamb of God and Mastodon's Ashes of Leviathan Tour. Tickets on sale now at LiveNation.com.
Let's go!
Let's go!
Don't miss the Jacksonville Sharks' first home game against the IFL defending champion Bay Area Panthers next Saturday, April 6th, at the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena, kickoff 7 p.m. Let's go! Let's show them what we got.
Let's go!
Tickets as low as $15. You can't find Saturday family affordable fun anywhere else. Call 904-621-0700 or go to jacksharks.com. Dust off your boots, grab your cowboy hat for Western night. Join us at 5 p.m. for Shark Fest, every home game located outside the arena for our pre-game party. Help us rock the tank as we roll out the 2023 NAL Championship Band.
Let's go!
Don't miss opening night of the season next Saturday, April 6th, 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena. Be a part of indoor football fun and exciting non-stop action. For tickets as low as $15, call 904-621-0700. Don't forget your cowboy hats.
Let's go!
Hey, Hicken here. You know I'm a hometown guy. There's nothing like home in Jacksonville, Florida. What a great place to live. Spring is here and everything is green and blooming. But that means I'll have to cut the lawn soon. It also means that we'll need to do some deep cleaning inside the house. That's where Zero Res comes in. Zero Res can clean your tile and grout, the carpets, your area rug, furniture, and more. Right now, they're offering 25% off tile and grout cleaning. Zero Res, man, spelling forwards or backwards. The right way to clean.
Zero Res.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Jaguars Today
on 1010XL.
All right, got a few more to go here. Tommy Mack joining us in studio tomorrow for a Friday Jaguars Today with ET in for Dylan tomorrow. Mike Dempsey, Tony Smith here with you. Right now, just a couple of odds and ends. Tone, we'll get to our look around the league here in a second. Tony Pauline, who usually joins us for multiple visits during draft season, we're hopeful to have him early next week to break things down. They have the big board. He's working over at Sportskeeda now, where he's their lead NFL draft analyst, and they have their big board of rankings up right now, which I presume – is Tony's personal big board, but I can't say that with 100% certainty. Mm-hmm. You know, I think we've all been conditioned. Like, I bet if I said, hey, Pockets, between you and Tony,
okay,
let's do this. I bet this would be an easy exercise. Give me the top 17 guys on Tony Pauline's big board without looking. Okay, they're not really many at anything crazy here. I bet you guys can do this without getting three strikes.
Four quarterbacks.
Well, which four quarterbacks?
McCarthy.
Yeah.
Caleb Williams.
Drake May.
Daniels.
Those four. Tony, you agree with those four?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see if McCarthy's in. Remember, this
McCarthy's
is.
McCarthy's the tricky one.
Yeah. Remember, Pockets, I think you busted already.
What?
J.J. McCarthy's ranked 28th.
Yeah.
What?
Doesn't mean he's not going to go in the top 17. This is his rankings. Okay. So we got one strike. You got three quarterbacks. Tony, give
Harrison
me a handful of guys.
Harrison Neighbors, Adunze.
Correct. Harrison, number one. Neighbors, number five. Adunze, number 10. This is one group's opinion.
Joe Alt's
in there. Yeah.
Brock Bowers.
Brock Bowers is number four. Excuse me, number four overall prospect.
How many DBs we going?
Tell me. Let's talk amongst yourselves.
Three DBs or four? I say three. Mitchell's probably the best one.
Mitchell's in there.
And it's 17 we're talking about here?
I want the top 17 players on the Sportskeeda board. You got one strike.
Terrion Arnold's
not in the top 17. Wow. He's 19th. Two strikes already for the fellas here.
So you got Cooper.
Give me some linemen here, yeah, man.
Well, Fonga, I would assume.
Let's see. He's got him at 14.
Okay.
Tali Fuanga out of Oregon State, 14th ranked.
Some other linemen.
Yeah. Give me a defensive lineman.
I want to say Byron Murphy, but I don't
know. Here you go. Okay. I'm going to help you out. 12.
Jared Verst.
He's 11. There you go. Offensive line. Still more offensive line in here.
Fatanu?
Fashanu. Not yet. The Fatuanu didn't make it. I'm going to give it to you now. He's at 25.
Okay.
Remember, this is, again,
some people say,
are you kidding me? He's not worse than 50. I don't know. In order, Harrison, Caleb Williams, Jaden Daniels, Brock Bowers at 4, Malik Nabers, Dallas Turner,
yeah,
of course. Mm-hmm. You just forgot him. Olu Fashanu at 7, Alt at 8, Drake May, Roma Dunze, Jared Verse, Byron Murphy, Chop Robinson. Mm. Oh, damn, they love his measurables, man.
In and out of that group, yeah.
I mean, they just love his measurables. I'm telling you, I'm terrified that they're going to draft a guy who didn't have college productivity. as an edge rusher. And five, if you do it in round five, we're used to that. We should be used to doing it in the middle of round one, too. We just moved on from Kalevon this offseason, but let's not do it again. Tali Fuanga, Quinyon Mitchell, Tyler Guyton, the other Oklahoma tackle.
Okay.
Who could pair up with Anton Harris. I saw somebody, I forget who it was, on Twitter, said something like, no way to project how Tyler Guyton and Anton Harrison could coexist on the same line, huh? Like, they're being facetious, obviously. They played together. Yes, we know exactly how they project. Yeah. And then right at 17, Brian Thomas, LSU wide receiver, 17th ranked prospect. Amarius Mims, Terrion Arnold, Johnny Newton, Kingsley Suamaitaia, right? You know the guy I'm talking about, the offensive tackle out of BYU?
Yeah.
Seen him now. Somebody's saying something about this guy. I'm starting to see him in the last five picks of a bunch of mock drafts in the first round, you know? So I have a feeling NFL teams are talking about him. Kool-Aid McKinstry and J.C. Latham, pair of Alabama Crimson Tide teammates. Adonai Mitchell out of Texas. Troy Faotanu. Leatu Latu, the edge rusher out of UCLA. Nate Wiggins, the corner out of Clemson. McCarthy, we mentioned he had a 28. Jackson Powers Johnson, by the way, 29th. That's terrible. I want him. He's got to be worth the 17th pick. Said someone, I'm sure. Jordan Morgan. You know who that is?
I've heard the name.
Arizona offensive tackle, Jordan Morgan. You got that one past the goalie this time.
Yeah.
Troy Franklin, the Oregon wide receiver, and Jatavion Sanders, who some people do have as the second tight end in the class, but interesting to see him have Sanders all the way up at 32. Cooper DeJean, by the way, at 33. So that's interesting. Graham Barton at 36. These are players that, you know, a lot of people have connected with the Jags. Ennis Rakestraw, 44, the corner out of Missouri. And then let's see, how about this? Keon Coleman at 48. So we're going to draft Brian Thomas and Keon Coleman right at value. Overturn that wide receiver room. Zay Jones, best fifth wide receiver in the league, Tone. I got to believe at that point in time.
Yeah.
Speaking of the league, let's go around it. Tony's got some highlights of what the other teams are up to.
Now, gems around the NFL. Brought to you by Beaches Jewelry and Pawn in Jack's Beach.
Just a couple of notes here. The Carolina Panthers and defensive end Jadeveon Clowney agreed to a two-year, $20 million deal with a max value of $24 million. Clowney made three straight Pro Bowls with Houston from 2016 to 2018. Since then, he has played for Seattle, Tennessee, Cleveland, Baltimore, and now Carolina in the last five-plus years. So it'll be five teams in 6 years there for Clowney. And Denver is signing wide receiver Josh Reynolds to a two-year deal, reportedly worth up to $14 million. He was certainly an effective number three wide receiver there in Detroit.
That's a nice little contract, right, for this late in the process. He's a good player. They moved on from Jerry Jeudy. Is at this point in their careers, not projecting ahead, has Josh Reynolds not been every bit as good as Jerry Jeudy? And I don't know what the numbers are because he hasn't always been as high in the pecking order among the Detroit wide receivers. I don't know if his numbers match him, but in terms of like down in, down out effectiveness, I don't see
it's been pretty good.
Denver's lost all that much right now. And look, Jerry Jeudy may still fulfill the promise that he had when he came into the league, but he hasn't done it at this point in time. So we'll see how that all shakes out. Jadeveon Clowney, man, he has bounced around an awful lot for a guy who is as athletic and powerful as he is. He's never been a big sack guy, though, has he? Until this year was one of his most effective seasons, which is a little interesting, Tone, that it was one of his most effective seasons putting up sacks, and still his market was kind of quiet, right? You signed this late in free agency, you certainly were not any team's top priority. It doesn't look like, you know, or anywhere near being their top priority. Hey, good for Carolina. And good for us that Jadeveon Clowney's not on a team that is of any consequence. Right?
Yeah.
That's teams like Carolina who have a long way to go. They sign players. I'm like, fine. You know, eventually they'll get better, but that's not our concern. We're not playing them. They're not in our division. They're not even in our conference. Don't have to give a second thought to the Carolina Panthers. We do need to give more thoughts to the dynamic between the Jags and Josh Allen. So we'll get to that coming up. Also want to play a couple of Doug Peterson sound bites. Just haven't had all the time this week to get to everything. He appeared on SiriusXM NFL Radio, so we'll hear a few of the things he had to say in that venue on Monday as we move through the week here of Jaguar football. This is Jaguars Today. Mike Dempsey, Tony Smith, Dylan Denmark on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Jaguars Today from the Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute Studios. Join the 1010XL Podcast Network.
Okay, excellent show, everyone.
Now you can find all your favorite 1010XL podcasts in your platform of choice.
Top Dog Tavern is your gathering place for family and friends, offering something for everyone. Want a delicious meal served with a smile? We have you covered. Shareable appetizers, hot and crispy wings, juicy tavern burgers, fresh salads, plus a large craft beer selection. And there is nowhere better to watch all the big games than on our multiple TVs. Enjoy great food, cold drinks, and good times at Top Dog Tavern, located in Bartram Park off Old St. Augustine Road.
Make your outdoor living perfect with Art of Natural Stone. Pavers, patios, gravel, pool decks, and more. Using all natural stone design, and they do the installation. Visit Art of Natural Stone on Route 1 near Bartram Springs or on Beach Boulevard.
This is Hayes Carlion for Skylife Elite. Have you ever thought about aircraft ownership as another potential revenue stream and as a tool for tax savings? Put your tax money to work for you while enjoying the benefits of private personal travel. SkyLife Elite has over a decade of experience in business aviation and can guide you through the process with their expert staff. Call my friends over at SkyLife Elite at 490-9332 or find them at flyskylife.com to get the rundown on everything owning an airplane can do for you.
Clayton, I've heard you talk about diamond grading reports from different laboratories. Don't all the diamond labs grade diamonds exactly the same way?
David, I wish I could say that all diamond grading laboratories were as accurate as each other, but they aren't, except for in one aspect, and that's the diamond's carat weight. All labs agree on what a diamond weighs, but that's where it stops. And if a customer's relying on both a store and an independent diamond grading report to give them the facts about a diamond's quality, they need to make sure that the grading reports from the Gemological Institute of America, or GIA, are from the American Gem Society Laboratory. These are the two independent diamond grading laboratories with untarnished reputations. In fact, at Underwoods, we don't accept any other laboratory's grading reports, and if you're interested in owning a quality diamond, you shouldn't either. You owe it to yourself to know exactly what you're buying in cut, color, and clarity.
At Underwoods, they tell you what you need to know, not just what you want to hear. In San Marco, Avondale, the shops of Ponte Vedra, Underwood Jewelers.
They know their sports.
So let's go out there and play our best.
And so do you.
Most of all, let's have fun.
Lauren, Taylor, and Mia.
Helmets and Heels.
Brightened by First Coast Lighting and Fans.
And presented by Underwood Jewelers.
Tuesday nights at 6 on 1010XL.
Frank Frangie here. I was born and raised in Jacksonville, and I love living here. But I also know how bad bugs are in Florida. So I trust Orange Environmental Services to handle all my pest control needs because they've got the best technicians and effective treatment. Their name may be Orange, but they think green. Orange Environmental has been serving the First Coast for over 50 years, and they now offer complete lawn maintenance services. Call Orange Environmental Services for peace of mind from bug problems today. Call them at 272-3284. That's 272-3284.
Visionaries, builders, and doers, are you ready to change the world? Miller Electric is your opportunity to shape the future. Miller Electric is leading the charge in electric vehicle technology with our state-of-the-art EV Innovation Design Center. We're working to create a sustainable future. We're also the proud partners of the Jacksonville Jaguars, powering their performance at the brand new Miller Electric Center. Miller Electric, we provide competitive pay, unbeatable benefits. Apply today. MillerCareers.com, Miller Electric, an equal opportunity employer.
Hey, Boost Mobile here to help you start from scratch. Boost is giving you the chance to win incredible prizes in our latest scratch-off sweepstakes, including up to $5,000 cash. With over 7,600 prizes up for grabs, this is an opportunity you don't want to miss. For your chance to win, just head to your local participating Boost Mobile store and ask for a scratcher. It's that easy. So visit a Boost Mobile store today and get after it. Ends 3/31/24 while supplies last. No purchase necessary. Other restrictions apply. Visit your local Boost Mobile store for details.
Dave Binion here with my son Ammon, who is the air duct cleaning manager at Zero Res. So Ammon, you may notice a little rattle in my voice and some puffiness in my eyes. That's because allergy season is coming on. Can Zero Res help?
Yes, your health has a lot to do with the air you breathe. A clean and healthy home begins with clean air. At Zero Res, we can help clean the air in your home by cleaning your air ducts, cleaning the coils in your HVAC units, and fogging the system with a powerful antimicrobial that helps kill and control the growth of microorganisms in your air. We also have options for maintaining your clean air with our excellent inline air purifier and UV lights that will help keep your system clean and healthy. At Zero Res, we are more than just air duct cleaners. We're a clean air specialist.
Have Zero Res air duct specialists out, and right now we'll give you $50 off your air duct cleaning, and while we're at it, we'll give you $50 off your dryer vent cleaning. Zero Res.
Spelled forward or backwards, it's the right way to clean.
C-E-R-O-R-E-C. Zero Res.
Breaking news, Jacksonville. Play It Again Sports is back. We are proud to be opening a brand new store on Merrill Road, but we need your help. We are currently stocking up and we need your gently used sports and fitness equipment. Play It Again Sports offers cash on the spot for all your used gear. We buy baseball, softball, football, hockey, lacrosse, golf, water sports. You name it, we buy it. Turn that gear into cash at Play It Again Sports Jacksonville on Merrill Road near 295 in the Merrill Station Shopping Plaza.
Lauren Brooks here from Mayport C&C Fisheries. Growing up at the beach, I know good shrimp and oysters when I see them. They're local and they're fresh. That's why Mayport C&C Fisheries is my go-to for both. They have local shrimp in stock 7 days a week. Eat like a local at Mayport C&C Fisheries.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
This is Jaguars Today on 1010XL.
Roma Dunze, the most fun guy the Jags could draft. That they have a chance to, even if they trade up. That's probably the most fun we can have.
I think so.
First draft night, right? Because they're like, let's be honest, right? I mean, it doesn't mean it's the best pick, by the way. Byron Murphy may be unbelievable, right? Maybe. Yep. The next whomever, right? And or any number of guys, right? Could be
it's
that guy.
It's the pick that fits a position that the Jags have indicated they feel like they need.
And it's a fun position.
Right. And it is. It's fun. You're getting your quarterback, maybe the number one wide receiver for the next 5 years of his career.
Some people would say, right? Brock Bowers would be the same thing. I'd be like, I don't know. I mean, are we just going to run two tight end sets all the time? I Roma Dunze would be. Again, I don't know that he'd be the best pick for them. I wouldn't be upset if they made that selection. And certainly if he fell to 17, I just can't see any scenario where he falls to 17.
Yeah.
There's enough teams that, I mean, who doesn't want in today's game a wideout who can do it all? You know, and if you get to a certain range, you're like, yeah, you know, wasn't thinking this way, but that's why you do that quote-unquote due diligence on a lot of these guys. All right, let's do a little bit more here with Doug Peterson. This is Doug on NFL Radio on Monday. Hear a few of his thoughts more on Trevor Lawrence. We got a few more that we'll get to tomorrow. Appreciate Doug for giving us a week of content here on Jaguars Today and 1010XL as a whole. What do the next steps look like for Trevor Lawrence?
He's a tremendous player, and you know, you've heard that phrase, you know, big-time players make big plays and big moments. Well, that's where he needs to get to now. We as a staff have to get him there, and it comes down with his work ethic, which is for us second to none. I mean, he comes in, he works extremely hard in the off season. He's a full participant in the off season, and to me, that's so important to have your starting quarterback, the face of your franchise, in the off season program, throwing to some of these young receivers and getting these guys going early and just being able to take that next step.
I hope he's right. You know what I mean? Like, I hope he's maximizing every opportunity he has. Trevor Lawrence, 3 years, you're never getting back. And I'm not saying he hasn't progressed to a certain degree.
No.
I think he's super talented. They were 8-3 before he started getting hurt.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like he has the greatest show on turf skill players around him.
No, and I do think to some degree it's unfair to say he's never risen in those moments. He has.
Absolutely.
Right? And it's that it didn't happen every time. Over the back half of this season.
And he's also put him in bad spots plenty of times.
And there were the questions, you know, with the turnovers and all those things that were going on, the end of the first half, right? Like, that kind of thing. Those situations rear their head from time to time with Trevor Lawrence. And you do have to weigh that against, well, he's the same guy who made the plays when they came back from 17 down against Baltimore.
That's right. And he's also the same guy that buried him against the Chargers.
It's
and
both.
Came back against
right.
the Chargers.
Like it's both with Trevor. Like, he's shown you he does have the ability to be exactly what Doug said he needs to learn how to be. Right? He's shown you he can be that. Right? It's trying to find the consistency in doing that. It's a really difficult step for a player to take. That's the Peyton Manning conversation we were having with John Osher yesterday. That's the conversation. When is this going to just be who you are? Right? When you take the field, we know this is what we're going to get every time. You know, it takes some time, you know, with some players to get to that point, but he's shown enough of doing that that you don't have to have your confidence shaken that he's going to be able to do it. It's when is this going to be a consistent thing that you can do?
But you use the word situations, and
sure,
you know, that just dovetails what Doug Peterson said next about Trevor Lawrence needing to understand situational football, and in those moments, make better decisions.
Understanding situational football, understanding, you know, we can't turn the ball over in the red zone, and we've got to make good decisions here, and it's okay to run, get out of bounds, slide. It's also okay to throw the ball away. So, you know, young quarterbacks right now, it's a little harder to get them to understand that.
I think the throw the ball away thing is the hardest one of all of those, mm-hmm. right? Like, you get immediate negative feedback when you force the ball in the end zone, right? If you get picked off. The point that we're at where we're still even mentioning it is a little bit disconcerting to me. You know, that this is something that should have been settled a couple of seasons ago. We thought we had moved beyond this. I don't like that being brought up right away. The running and learning how to protect yourself, that's something that develops as well, I think, along the way. Some guys come into the league a little bit more preternatural in their ability to avoid the contact. But, you know, there's a fine line between I want to be a tough guy, but I also want to live to fight another day. It's the getting a young quarterback who's got all the arm talent in the world to sail one out of bounds intentionally when it's just not there.
When
I think
his head is telling him, I can make that throw.
I can make that throw. I can make that throw. I can make them tougher throws than that.
It's hard to get his brain to stop saying, I can make that throw, unless it's a moment where it's, you got to make the throw or we lose. Right? Like, there will
Correct.
Be those
sure.
kind of moments, right, where it's like, don't turn that off at all. That voice that's in your head saying, make the throw, make the throw.
Yeah.
And trying to figure out at what point in your career you go from, I have to make the throw to, man, it'd be cool if I did, right? Like, there has to be the difference between those two in your head. It's like halfway through the second quarter, you don't have to make that throw right now, man.
Right.
Next play. Like, that has to be part of the mentality. We live to play the next play. If it's the end of a fourth quarter, a tight game, and I got to make the play to win the game, try it, man. Right? And no one's going to – like, I'm not going to be mad at you for trying, you know, in that kind of situation. It's – everyone's going to be, what are you doing – when he's done it in some of the situations that he has.
Right. This is related to, like, the internal clock, but it's not the exact same thing. Like, the internal clock, sometimes you just got to get rid of it because you know at a certain point in the NFL danger is coming, right?
Yeah.
And you want to balance that with not being too fast to get rid of the football. You want to go through your progressions, but your offensive line plays a big role in this. It's that beyond, you know, the throw it away when nothing's there is more like, it's very related, but that to me is more like what you just said, I can make any throw on the football field.
Yeah.
And even if this is not a high percentage smart play, you save that for when your chances of winning are not a high percentage play. Like you said, it's the last 2 minutes of the game. You got to make the throw. It's fourth down. Let it rip. Fine. But middle of the second quarter, got to have a little discernment.
Yeah, I know. You know, we've gone through the last couple of years with Doug, and they've been willing to be very aggressive in situations where they can kick field goals, go for it on fourth downs, all those kind of situations. We know they're going to be aggressive. I've come to terms with that. Like watching this team for the last 2 years, when they get in those situations, my expectations have become they're going to go, right? So I'm not judging him as harshly on the whether or not I would go in those situations because I know what my expectation is. He's going to go. And there is a little bit of that with Trevor in those situations as well, in my mind. It's like, I want him to get better at managing those game situations, but I'm not all that angry at him for trying because I do believe in the talent, right? Like, I'm not the guy throwing the ball, but I believe in the guy that's throwing the ball, that he wants to try to make that hero play. I'm not saying that he needs to be the hero all the time, and I don't think Doug is wrong saying basically, we don't need him to be Superman all the time. He's not wrong, right, in those kind of things. But I think it's really hard to figure out where do we pump the brakes on that to get him optimally performing for us where we're not hurting the development of the player, because I do, there is, it's a fine line.
Yeah.
It's not an easy one to find.
But there's a difference between, like, going back to last year, like, hey, Calvin Ridley can make some really tough contested catches. I'm going to give him a chance that I might not give, even though he looks like he's covered here. And we've seen him throw a few balls that were like, did that literally go through a defensive player's body? Like, how did that
he's
get
got
there?
That ability, yeah.
But it's the ones, like, you know, where he threw the Derek Stingley pick in the end zone a couple years ago, where the guy's sitting right in front of you. And you, and it's like,
he didn't see it.
Did you even see that guy?
He didn't see that guy.
You've got to do a better job of reading the field in those situations. And that became something that cropped up more than once.
And that's a different situation than I can make that throw. That's a situation where I didn't see the guy.
I agree. And that's a bigger problem. Right? Yeah. You're always going to have a little bit with a Mahomes or a Lawrence or anybody that's got crazy arm talent.
Yeah,
occasionally
and I
they're
going to
make a decision that's...
Yeah, plenty of times this year I saw Mahomes make a throw. It's like, how did he not see that guy?
Right.
It's right there. I saw Mahomes do it half a dozen times this year. It happens to NFL quarterbacks. You know, when it's your quarterback, you tend to focus in on it a lot
and
more.
And because I know it's coming now, because if you mention their names anywhere near proximity, Trevor ain't Mahomes, and he's never going to... Nobody said he was, but he's got crazy arm talent.
He does.
If you deny that, then you're just... Don't.
We can hardly have a conversation about the guy.
That's a good way to put it, all right? All right. Yesterday's question of the day, by the way, we asked you based on where the roster stands, which position or group would you least like to see the Jags take? Final tally on that. Defensive tackle, a third of the people said, nope, let's not do that in the first round. 26% went with edge rush, 22% went with wide receiver, and 18% went with offensive line. So if you flip it and everyone voted the way the question was presented, that means you'd be – happiest with offensive line or least angry with offensive line in the first round, even though there's no obvious starting position available at the moment. Okay. Today, we asked you, when will the Jags get a contract extension done with edge rusher Josh Allen? Is it before the NFL draft? If not, then by the July 15th franchise tag extension deadline next offseason, or they just won't get one done? Tony, I know you're not either of the first two, so. Next offseason, or will they not get a deal done with Josh Allen?
I'm trying to remain as hopeful as I can next offseason.
Next offseason, right?
Yeah.
That puts you in the group voting 13%.
Yeah.
I'm going to say by the July 15th deadline. I think there's still plenty of time to get this done.
I certainly
hope
so.
There's no excuse. There's no reason, no logical reason why you can't get it done. If you're ever going to find common ground, you got months to do it still. So do it. You know, I'm not writing off the NFL draft. I don't know. I just think there's a lot of other things going on. If I were the Jags, I do think it behooves you leverage-wise to make a little bit of a push before the draft and say, hey, look, man, if we're not sure how many years you're going to be here, that's going to open us up to the possibility of taking other guys at your spot and maybe you playing here on the franchise tag for a couple of years. I don't know if they do that.
Yeah.
But I'd use all the leverage I had.
I try to go back into my mind about how I felt about the Ingram process, right, when we were going through it at this point last year. And I wasn't confident they were going to get it done before the draft. I was confident the whole time, though, that they were going to get the deal done because it always made the most sense for everybody involved to get it done. And I didn't think the numbers were going to be crazy. I do think the money with Josh should be so high that I wouldn't be surprised if Balky blinks, right, at the money, right? Not the player, but I wouldn't be surprised, given the way last offseason played out, if he says, do it again.
What if he does that and Josh Allen goes out and has 8 sacks this year and they franchise tag him again and he has 7.5 the year after that, right? And last year was the outlier. Then what's the money for Josh Allen at that point?
I don't know what the money would be.
Right, I'm just saying, like, from his perspective,
that's the gamble that Trent Baalke is willing to make.
Or it's got to be one Josh Allen's willing to make, too.
Like, I'm not willing to make the gamble. I'd pay him.
I understand, but you think next offseason?
Yes.
I'm going to go by July 15th.
And I feel like I'm maybe being a little bit hopeful. Like, I'm torn between next offseason and eventually they just don't get it done.
All right, let's see what Mia O'Brien thinks as we welcome in XL Primetime. Mia, today, we've talked a lot about Josh Allen. This is kind of more of a background topic today, but Mike DiRocco on Monday said he wouldn't be shocked if they got something done with him by the draft, which surprised me, but okay. So they got 4 weeks there. Before the draft, if not then, before the July 15th deadline, next offseason, or never get an extension done. What's the most likely thing with Josh Allen?
Before July 15th.
That's what I vote as well. How confident are you in that? that they will get it done.
Rather confident. I think it stems from, I don't want to say public pressure, because I believe that Trent Baalke would be A-okay with making Josh Allen prove it again and play on the franchise tag. I truly believe that. With that said, I think he recognizes that, and again, he doesn't care what the public persona of him may be, but he recognizes that for this brand to be valuable and to be something that people want to be a part of, Josh Allen is a guy that not only do fans clamor to, but other players want to play with. Now, is he a top five, top three edge rusher? I mean, we need to see it in back-to-back seasons, I think. But at the same time, we know he's at least top 10. And those guys aren't walking around the earth and not readily available. And you can't guarantee you're going to find another one of those in the draft or on the street and develop them like you have Josh Allen.
How, if at all, does it change the pressure on either side? Like, if the Jags were to draft Jared Verse, if he fell to 17.
Yep. Which, by the way, I see a world in which they get a deal done with Josh and they still draft Jared Verse.
Okay.
Yes.
But if they, let's say they don't before the draft,
yep,
and you draft Jared Verse, does that give Baalke a little more like, hey, you know, Josh, we're willing to get a deal done, but we're not going to get stupid here because we can tag you again next year, and we do have this new guy as well. We got plenty of pass rush now.
Yeah.
So you want to hold out. You're only costing yourself money. You know, so a little bit of an interesting dynamic.
Yeah, it's for sure an interesting dynamic, and I know Leon's brought it up on primetime, and we've had plenty of nooners text in and be like, you know, even when Leon wasn't here, I forget what day it was, he was on vacation, and they were like, well, you know, like Leon said, if they draft Jared Verse, then that's sending a bad message to the locker room. And I don't think it's sending a bad message to the locker room. Look at San Francisco and how they loaded up on pass rushers. Look at how many street free agents the Baltimore Ravens signed in free agency. Look at all of the draft capital that, you know, Detroit, Green Bay,
yeah,
right. Like, having multiple pass rushers is not a bad thing. I don't think that's saying to the locker room, they're over Josh, they're going to make Josh play on 1 year.
But not all those situations. Obviously, you got a guy coming off the 17.5 sack season. We know on the free agent market, he'd be a top five paid guy at the position. With all, it's not all the same. It's not like Aiden Hutchinson is got the franchise tag on him and Detroit's like, we're going to take a pass rusher in the middle of the first round. You know, wink, wink, has nothing to do with you, Aiden. So I do think the circumstances are a little bit different.
I think that the way that you spin that is, yes, Josh Allen, like, if you, let's say they are to draft Jared Verse, and that's with or without an extension for Josh Allen in hand by late April, what they're going to spin it and say is, yes, Josh had 17.5 sacks. Yes, Trayvon had 10.5. The entire team had 40.
Understood. All right. Mm-hmm. I'm not, like, and again, I think it's a very strong position. At the same time, I'm not upset if they take a guy who turns out to be a really good player.
Especially because it's such a weak edge class this year, too.
Yeah,
so
there are two or three that are first-round viable, and they might not all fit, and they might not make it to you, and that includes Verse. Do me a favor. Give Tony a little fist bump, will you? Yeah. Wonder Twin Powers. Let Mia's positivity absorb and Tony.
You know how I stand on it.
I've even got, you know, I'm betraying Mike Dempsey right now. I wore the Braves cap, not the Yankees.
I almost just said a bad word.
It's only because it matches. I have my new Liverpool quarter zip I got across the pond. So I had to wear the gray. I did try a Yankee hat.
You like the people that wear Yankee stuff as a fashion statement.
I tried the Yankee hat on first. Yours is a little bit of a darker navy. Mine was like a brighter blue for some reason. Maybe it was the lighting in my bedroom. I don't know. But I was like, why is it not matching? So that's why I went with this one.
What are you doing on the show today? I don't even talk
we
to you
apparently, I was obviously absent the last few days across the pond with family stuff. So the boys did not, they forewent their mock draft Wednesday yesterday. So we're going to do that today since I'm back in the house. We're also going to look at some NFL win totals. I'll leave you guys with this. Tony, Mike, any guesses what the Atlanta Falcons, line is? 8.5?
Mm-hmm.
Tony?
I would have guessed 7.5.
9.
Okay.
And a half.
I thought it was 8.5. Is it
9.5?
That's
according to J.J. LaSelva and whoever, I guess we got it from Jimmy Shapiro, it's 9.5. So we will look at that. We'll look at who else is in the middle of the pack with the Jags and also maybe some AFC South totals or AFC South odds, I should say.
I don't really blame them for 9.5, though. They got a massive quarterback upgrade and they play in a generally weak division.
That's
so,
what I said.
You know, that's not surprising.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if the Falcons make the playoffs and lose whatever first game Kirk Cousins plays in the playoffs.
I might be surprised if they don't make the playoffs when the dust all settles, you know.
They were close to it last year.
I know the Bucks won it last year. That doesn't shock me as well. I don't think that there are a lot of factors that go into those. But, yeah, the Jags are right there. And then, well, you know, you look at the who are the contenders to take down Kansas City articles, right? The Jags are right in the middle of the AFC pack. Mm-hmm. So what? We were high in the list last year, and it doesn't win you a damn thing.
Correct.
So just go play the games and win. Mia, have a great show.
Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome back. All right, that'll do it for us today. Pockets! Have a good weekend, bro.
I appreciate it.
You sticking a peg in the ground this week or
no,
what?
No, I got Easter weekend. Saturday too, and I got Easter family
stuff.
You're
going to be chasing that little bunny around the yard? All right. Yeah. Enjoy.
Get
all right.
$5.
Well, and good luck to the Baldwin men's and ladies dominating and every other Jacksonville school that's got athletic competition
appreciate
this weekend.
It.
There you go. All right. That'll do it for us. ET will be in tomorrow for Dylan and Tom McManus. Will be in for Tom McManus on the program.
Yes.
Tony will be in for Tony, and I will be here as well. And that'll do it for us. Stick around. XL Primetime is next here on 1010 XL and 92.5 FM.
Jaguars today from the